So I'm on Omarchy, and as you've seen from the other videos, I've done creative tools and we can get the resolve working and it's all fine, works great. So creatives, Omarchy is a great distro, OS, bash script to use. However, obviously the, you know, the other part of Linux is gaming, and Steam's built on Arch, which is what Omarchy is built on. So I need to run it through some games tests. I mean, obviously, if you purely want to play games and that's your thing, Bazzite is pretty much the way to go. I mean, that case is for everything and it's brilliant. And the guys behind Bazzite, great job. Omarchy is a bit different. I need to work. So I need to work quickly and I need an intuitive interface. Bazzite's not the same thing. So while Bazzite's got loads of amazing things and great games, so is Catchy. Catchy's great as well, actually. It's not quite like this for me working flying around the windows, tiled window manager, and it's streaming, you know, it's cut down and good for me. But I did like to play the odd game. So, you know, so the thing is, can it do gaming? So that's what we're going to do. We're going to have a look at that. I mean, you know, the chap behind this, David, has sort of aimed it at developers, and I think he did another thing called Omicub. Anyway, that's all aimed at developers. But, you know, this is brilliant. This is brilliant for creatives. So, I mean, you know, is it any good for games? So there you go. Let's have a look. I've loaded up a few games from Steam. Some of the generics we've always seen, like Cyberpunk and things like that. And what we'll do is we'll look at those games and then we'll have a look at what you do if there's a problem with the game as well. Anyway, so let's dive in. Okay, so here we are, we're in Steam, and I've got a couple of tiles over the side here. So let's just do old school Call of Duty Black Ops. It's probably the best Call of Duty game they ever did. Well, there's another one as well, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. It's the one with that. It's the one with Chernobyl being it. That's great. But this is a really good one as well. So up it comes. I pre-run these, so they should work. Okay, so let's just jump in, press any key, campaign, settings, graphics all okay. Just go back to campaign and always resume game. Yes. Not sure where I was with this, but it runs fine. So I'll just sort of have a quick couple of minutes on it with just left mouse to skip. Oh, here we go, what's going on? Okay, we've just got this Castro mission. I'm supposed to take the guy in with the knife. I can do that. It's pretty gruesome. But it's done now. No, I don't want to know. That's a rubbish gun. Let's go. But perfect. I mean, this is on maximum settings. On 4K. I've got everything cranked up and it's running really well. Probably should have done that. Got it. Oh, that's not a good way to start a mission. Anyway, there you go. It works perfectly. Let's come out of that. Let's come out of that. So, COD, fine. Save and quit. And let's get out of that. So, last bit. So that runs really smooth. I mean, this is a 60 hertz refresh rate monitor. It's a 5060 Ti. So it should really, the AAA's, modern AAA games, it should really work really well at 1440p. So let's do Cyberpunk. Play. That should launch up. Give it a second. I'm getting Borderlands 4 shortly, so that should be quite good because that's quite heavy on the machines. So I'll try and get that to run on here. But there's no problems launching, just off it goes. Come on. space to continue. Breaching. Let's click continue, see if I've got a load of game. Let's see if I've got anything that's not right at the beginning. The Nomad. What's that one? The Nomad. Let's get that. Space to continue. When I come out, I'll jump into the settings to show you. So let's just jump in the car. F to get in. Yeah, looks pretty good. So this is running 1440p. Let's just go off-road, see what happens. Oh, nothing out there for you, turn back. So you broke the game straight away. Anyway, okay, so that's great. Let's have a look at settings. What have we got going on? We've got graphics. Ray tracing is on medium. Video-wise. And video load agency, Vsync 60. 4040p, so fine. You can definitely game. I mean, I think the key thing I'm working for before we even get to performance is, can it run? So let's try this. This is EMPYREAL. Not sure what that one is. Some kind of open world loop type game. Not quite sure. I haven't really don't know anything about it that much. But, you know, they're launching fine. At the end, I'll show you the problems. That's what we're waiting for. I mean, they don't all run fine. Okay, here we go. Press that to start. Continue. Here we go. This is not quite sure what... what's that there then? Okay, let's try. Where are we? Down there. Oh, a monster thing. Let's go for it. Okay. All those guys are dead. There's a thing to pick up. Yeah, so it's over-the-shoulder type running around. A lot of shooting, whatever. There's probably a massive, brilliant game I'm missing here. There's a thing there. Do I need to get that? I don't know what that does. Consumables. Let's go up there quickly. New tutorial available. Don't know what that is. So, I think there's a scary thing. There's, I'll give you a... There we go, these guys. Oh. Got that guy. Got them all, did I? That's interesting. That was pretty quick combat. And I was just clicking, no skill required here, just clicking on the left. Got some knee pads out of it. Teleporter. Well, there you go. Whatever this game is, looks pretty cool, actually. It works really well. Settings, what have we got settings on? Video. So I've got DLSS4, so I've got frame gen on. I've got, so it all seems to work really well on here. Text is high, frame limit. There's a lot to play with them. I have to come back and play with that. But yeah, it seems to work okay. Yeah. Quick to desktop. So there you go. So a lot of them work off the bat. Now, I've got too much, but I don't think it's worth showing you. It works, and it gets 60 frames a second with it. It does on the standard benchmark. But to launch it, I had to do this. So if you go to properties, I had to put specific drivers in for X11 to get it to boot. Otherwise, it wouldn't play. You'd get an STL error at the beginning. And this is the same for Black Mesa. If I try and run it, you get this. comes up, there should be an error box. It's not even giving me that anymore. Okay, so let's go in there and properties. I put a command in just to try and delete that. And let's try it now. There, it goes SDL int video failed, Wayland X11 not available. So what you can do, now I've already screen captured this, and I've worked out workspace, because one of the great things about having AI on your desktop is you can bring up your ChatGPT here, and then what I did, go back to it too, I just screen captured this, which you do like this, print screen, grab that, and then save it. Okay, go back to my workspace, go into my pictures folder, pictures. That's one of these, I took one yesterday, today. So I'm trying to run Black Mesa on Omarchy, which is Arch based via Steam, and I get this error. So just drag the screenshot over and send it off. So you, like Workspace 3 for me is like a mini game fixing zone. There we go. So you can in Steam go, I could put that in, or in Wayland force it to stay native. So if you want to stay, let's try, that doesn't work. Let's try this to stop, confirm. And then we just give it that properties, put that in there, play. Let's see what it does. No, failed again. But you see my point here. You could now work through, make sure you've got Wayland installed, Proton versus native. It starts to give you suggestions, step-by-step guide for setting up Black Omarchy, covering Proton seconds, and it'll actually work through. If you're that keen to get the game going, you can work through it. But I mean, overall, all of the games played, apart from Tomb Raider and, let's go back to it, apart from Tomb Raider and Black Mesa, I can't get running at the moment, but I would imagine that most of the modern games will run properly. I know that something like Black Mesa worked perfectly in Catchy, so there's a bit of tweaking. At the moment, I've also got settings, compatibility. I've got G Proton, which is the glorious egg roll version. And if you don't know what that is, just Google it. But there's the thing. It's not obviously as slick for gaming off the bat. I mean, Bazzite, all of those games would run immediately, and there'd be absolutely no problem whatsoever. So if you're looking at Omarchy from a gaming perspective, I'd sort of give it a 7 out of 10. It's not really designed for that. I built it for developers. So me shoehorning gaming on top of it is a bit of an extra, isn't it? But you can do it, and it works. If you want to spend a little bit more time and you have a little bit more knowledge, then you can get the games running. But I mean, if you're coming in from a different direction where you want to work, you want to develop, you want to create, and you want to do a game on a PS5 or do something different, or play some of the later AAA titles that seem to work okay on here, that's great. But I think, you know, it's got some potential compatibility issues due to like the Wayland X, whatever it is, the tiling manager thing. I mean, in the actual menu itself, you do have a gaming section. He hasn't forgotten about it. So if you go to install, actually, let's get to a new window. So if you go to, where are you? Install, you can see he's got gaming at the bottom there. Now, that's where you install Steam. You've got RetroArch and Minecraft. So it's been thought of. So you need a tiny little bit of nerd knowledge maybe to get some of the games working, but not much. So there you go. I hope that's helpful. If you do play games on Omarchy and you find this particular solution, just post me in the comments. Or if you've got any questions, I can have a look. I mean, at the end of the day, you've got AI. And AI can basically do, look at it. It can do tons. You can just sit here and beaver away whichever AI you choose to use and work out the solution to the problem. And that's a good segue to the next thing I'll do about Omarchy. I'll talk about using AI on it. Because again, very smartly, they've built in some, go back to the right screen, let's go to that one. They've built in a whole installation area here for AI. So let's have a look at that. Anyway, thanks for watching.